Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning. I wanted to share with you something, one of the many experiences that I had. Each time that I fast, the Holy Spirit will give me a theme. I will know that that's what we are going to do. And this time around, I knew that I would do 7 days on the 10 days on the floor. And I was preparing myself, you know, mentally, because it's a challenge. And I don't like starting something and not finishing it. I like to start and finish and do a good job. And as I was repenting, cleaning up my life, taking care of my physical hygiene, I went to bed. That was the previous, so that was August 29th. And I had a dream. I saw myself in my hometown, in Katanga, in the city of Lubumbashi. I saw this man that I know, and he was wiping an LP, but it was not black, but it had a rainbow, you know the colors? And I looked at him, I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm wiping my LP. I said, why? He said, because I would like to play this disc so that the atmosphere will play that music and people will hear it and will act according to what the music is telling them. So I said, but your disc is not black like it usually is. This one is has the rainbow, like the LGBT, the alphabet people rainbow. He said, yes, that's what I want to introduce and I want to release in the state of Katanga. And I said, and why will you do that? He said, because if I do that, then I will get so many benefits from Satan, and that's what I would like to do. I told him, I said, I cannot allow you to do that. And that's how I woke up. So I knew that that was the theme of this fast. So I woke up, I sat on the floor, and as I prayed, I was led by the Holy Spirit, and I marvel by what God does. I was repeating, those were His words, not mine. I did, and I said what He told me. I don't know how long I was there for. You know, when you fast, I just zoom out. I don't even check my clock because I don't want to be the human being affected and say, oh, it's too long. Or no, I can catch up, you know, in the afternoon and rest. So I prayed, I finished. I went back to bed. I woke up at 6 a.m. I was vomiting, really vomiting for like a good 30 minutes. I was just vomiting, but water, it was clear, just clear water. I was really affected by that, you know. That's an interesting way of waking up. And after vomiting, I started having a serious case of diarrhea. It lasted 10 days. I was hurting. I didn't know if I was going or coming. I didn't know. Food didn't have a taste in my mouth. I was really affected. I am shaking my head. We had a victory. Praise the Lord, we had a victory. So, when you go on a specific territory and you see people doing things a certain way, first of all, look for the border. There is a border, there is a boundary, a spiritual boundary and a physical boundary. But more than that, people are listening to music. You have places that are so clean, you feel good when you get there. And then you have other places that are so dirty. You feel dirty when you're there. So I discovered that, and we were able to vanquish that spirit. God did it. I saw His angels. I saw them. Ooh. You know, when He says, they shall surely assemble, but not because of me. Isaiah 54:17. Behold, I have created the silversmith that blows on the coil and produces a weapon for his work. Ooh, I saw them. Those destroyers. People of God, the Bible is real. I am debating with people. People who are telling me that Jesus didn't exist, and this and that. To me, is real. I serve him, I work for him. The Bible is the word of God, and we did it, we finished. I finished on the 10th, and that's when I discovered that Dr. Eka passed away. I didn't know that that was a mighty trial. That was really, really, if I didn't have this combative spirit, because I've always been like that, I would have just run away and hide, you know, like a ostrich, and put my head like in the sand and say, leave me alone, leave me alone. That's what I was feeling like. And my son wanted to help me like he usually does. That's cute. He fasted 4 days. He had the exact same symptoms. But we finished. I am pleased. I am proud to announce to you that the Holy Spirit did it. He did it. I marvel. I am in awe. So watch people when they act a certain way. What kind of music do they are listening? When you look at musicians that we have today that are very popular, well known, you see the face, you know the name, they all have the same kind of appearance. Tattoos, piercings, they all exude that lustful spirit. So they are singing in the natural, and you have another voice in the spiritual that is singing. So when you put that together, that's how you get this debauchery, this perdition, and the people are really are lost, because they are listening to a music that is leading them on a certain path instead of being led on the path of righteousness for his name's sake, like the verse says. That's what I wanted to share with you. So who are you listening to? What music leads you? You need to be careful. People of God, we are living in the last perilous times. This September, we have Rosh Hashanah, the head of the year. Things are different, so many activities. Doors are closing, shift. There is a change of God for concerning so many things. I will do another video talking about that. My assignment is Africa. Oh, I love the Lord. I love the Lord. Thank you very much. God bless you. And I'll see you next time.